to Galilee, to the table, to the fish net, away from this ancient holy city. He was dead, irrevocably, finally, unchangeably, God.
Alive again, and then he began to speak to us and teach us. Simon, son of John, do you love me?
Lord, you know my heart as well as you know everything. You know I love you.
Then you are my heirs. While you were younger, you were able to go where you wished and do what you wanted. But now, as you grow older, others follow you, and sometimes they will lead you where you do not wish to go. Follow me.
Living in the past, let us live in the reality of now.
must be patient. We must have faith. But now the Lord is—he's not here with us now. Does that mean our faith should be as absent as he is?
If we do not believe now, then how can we believe all the things he did for us while he was here? If we give up now, then he hung upon that cross and died for nothing. You must believe, Thomas. You must.
Oh.
He took them to a mountain in Galilee, for it appeared to them for the last time before ascending into heaven. He said, go and preach the gospel to all nations. And then he said, most of all, remember this. No matter where you are or what you are doing, I am with you always, even until the end of time.
Do you know, dear Lord, that this good gift with my family being like they are, they'll think this is going much too far. Far as I can tell right now, praying for Mr. Saul is out.
For tomorrow we're dead!
Oh, my brothers, get get some sense in your head and stop this sinning. For there are some among you who do not even know God. And I say this for your shame. For just as death was brought by the original sin of Adam, so it has been conquered with the crucifixion of Christ. I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live. Yet not I, but Christ lives in me. For me, to live is Christ, and to die is gain. For the life I live now, I live by faith in Jesus Christ, who loved me and gave himself for me. For me, he lives, and because he lives, I live. All the miracles that Jesus performed were done for a purpose, so that you and all those about you may believe that there is life in Jesus' name.
Chapter of Distributed Education Clubs of America. I was my chapter president. I later became president of the whole state of collegiate devils when I was a freshman in college. And still those offices that I held, it never brought me the joy and the peace that I was searching for. And so I tried other things. I tried, got involved with the wrong crowd of people and partied with them in high school, and then when I got into college, it got worse. I played rugby for 2 seasons, and we had a party one night that I went to, and I did a lot of things there that I shouldn't have done. And up until this time, I was at least playing the church. I was going to church on Sunday mornings and thought that that was enough for me, that I was doing my spiritual bit for the week by going to church on Sunday morning. Well, because the party was on Saturday night, I was in no condition to get up Sunday morning. And I woke up about 12 o'clock or something, and I was in Garcia Hall. And I just sat in my bed, and I just prayed, or just said this to God. I said, Lord, I'm a major screw-up. I've got to get my life straightened out. See, I had a twin sister who has always had a really secure relationship with the Lord. She's always done what God wanted her to do. And I saw that in her, and I knew that that's how I should be. But I wasn't willing to let Christ live through me until then. And I went and came to talk to our pastor here, and I told him all the stuff I did, which I didn't bother telling you. And he just looked at me and goes, Ken, we all do stupid things. And I was like, what a concept. Here's a pastor. See, I was used to pastors, even though they didn't mean to, they would judge me, or I perceived them to judge me for what I was doing. And when he said that, it gave me real peace, and I knew that this is where I should plant my life, and that I should start living my life totally for the Lord. And I told him, I said, my sister's just going to think I'm going through a phase. That, you know, I don't get religious for a while, I'm going to slack back off. And he told me, he said, the way to disprove that is to stay consistent, to stay in the church, and keep being, you know, productive for Jesus was what he was saying. And so I have for that, I don't know, it's been 3.5 years or so. And I've slipped and I've fallen back into my old ways. But the center and the focus of my life is Jesus. And I strive to do what he wants me to do. And I keep a short account of my sins to make sure I'm living for him. And I strive to be a living witness. And that's what all of us should strive for.
I've also learned, as a human being, there's going to be times Jesus is Lord, and you believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, the Bible says you will be saved. And it says that whoever will call upon the Lord will be saved. And this has been done tonight that you might have eternal life, that you might believe he is alive. And not only believe that, but trust your life to him. I want to ask all of us to bow our head in prayer. And it may very well be that you believe that Jesus rose from the dead, but you've never committed your life to him. You've never asked him to enter your heart, your life. And you've never said what Thomas said. You've never said, my Lord, my God, Christ. Right now, tell him that. Open your heart to him. Ask him to enter you and to give you life. Father, thank you for the faithful presentation of the good news. Thank you for the witness of people who live and saw our Lord Jesus and those who are witnesses today. We pray that you would cause the miracle of the new birth to take place in people tonight, and that hearts would be regenerated, and that spiritual death would be converted to spiritual life. We pray that you would give people what it takes to confess you as Lord. We thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We're going to stand, and as a congregation, we're going to sing a hymn of invitation. If you pray to trust Christ as your Savior and Lord, I'm going to be here at the front. There will be others who will be here at the front. And I'll ask you, as we begin to sing, just to come forward. By coming forward, you are manifesting publicly that your faith is in Christ. If you pray tonight, and you're ready to confess him as your Lord and Savior, this is the first step. We'll make arrangements for you to be baptized, and in that way, confess him as your Lord and Savior. And maybe it will be that God has called you to be a part of this church. If you'll meet me here at the front, we'll talk about that a moment, and you can be a part of Calvary if God is leading you in that way. And it may be there's some other decision you need to make. This is the time to do it. Would you stand, please?